Hello everyone, hope you are doing well. Welcome to Science and Tech series with Dr. Ved Rana. Topic for today's discussion is once again from defense section. There is a INS Kavrati which has been commissioned into Indian Navy. So it is a busy week. We have back to back. This is the third defense update in matter of 3 days. So you can say that India is really pushing hard in the defense sector and is on this is overall a good news for the naval as well as overall our military authority. So we'll be decoding what is the significance, what exactly is this INS Kavrati. So let's decode it. So first of all, the brief description about this Indian naval ship Kavrati. So first, we all know Kavrati is named after a capital of one of the Union territories. So the nomenclature part is not too difficult to decode in this particular case. Otherwise, the other ship in the series of which it belongs are quite tricky. They can make you you can make a mistake in those. So it is an anti-submarine corvette of Indian Navy, and the highlight is almost 90% of the parts have been indigenously designed. So that makes it once again in line of Atmanirbhar Bharat vision. So we have to congratulate the team working for this construction. So first of all, which is the naval dockyard which is involved in the construction of this INS Corvette? So it is the Kolkata based Garden Reach Shipbuilders and Engineers, which has a long history of preparing such vessels. And the induction part is it has been inducted by Indian Navy and Vishakhapatnam dockyard. At Vishakhapatnam dockyard, so make sure you are familiar with the locations of these two places, because it is under my interchange, because Vishakhapatnam also has a shipbuilding center which also is involved in construction of such vessels. So coming to the class, this is the tricky part. We all know the first, whenever you create something new, the first in the line is the one on which the class nomenclature is based. So the first anti-submarine warfare corvette in this under Project 28 was INS Kamorta. So this Kamorta class is the nomenclature which is being followed. So when you will be reading the newspaper, you will come across the word, it's the Kamorta class submarine or corvette. So make sure you don't get confused in it, because this is larger context of thing. There were four corvettes which had to be constructed under Project 28, and this is the fourth and the final one. So the series get completed. So you can see the other anti-submarine warfare corvettes in the INS Kamorta class are the INS Kamorta, the first one, the second is INS Kadamar, and the third is INS Kiltan, and this the fourth K is Kavrati. So they can ask that what is the nomenclature of these anti-submarine corvettes which they follow. So by Kavrati, I think is more or less you might have decoded already. It is based in Kavrati is the capital of Lakshadweep Island. So all these ships are based on the names of islands which are located off Lakshadweep Islands. Make sure you just go through these names and familiarize, because if they had asked INS Kiltan or Kamorta directly, most of you might not have been able to relate that what exactly is the nomenclature, whether it's the mountain ranges, whether it's the name of some ancient cities, or it could be some historical aspect which we have seen in the case of the Scorpion survey. So the highlight of this mission is going to be that it's the one of the first, you get the state of art indigenously designed radar system is being used for this corvette, and it is quite accurate, and it makes it quite competent to just counter the submarines which are destructive with the help of course the torpedoes and the missile system. So once again, this project is being highlighted under Atmanirbhar Bharat and because of indigenization of technology. So more or less this is a part of our larger context of things, because we know that how the seas are, we need to express ourselves in seas, because China is asserting itself not only South China Sea and East China Sea but also in Indian Ocean region through string of pearls. So we should be prepared for any eventualities, and this is part of larger plan to counter the China. So this will come in handy, because the submarines we all know are quite destructive because of stealth features, but to counter them such warfare comes into the play. So India is making timely strides and upgrading our naval forces. So once again we have to congratulate the Defence Forces for this achievement and make sure you also update this part in the Indian naval ships section, because we had covered the naval submarines, the aircraft carriers and the most prominent warships, and this orbit part would also be added in the note, because since it is in news after a long, because the first three were constructed way back right from 2014-16, so after a long time this orbit is in news, so it's the time to upgrade, and since the series is completed now a question can be. I hope this short update on INS Kavrinthi was useful to all of you. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.